If you want more enjoyment out of hiking, it is important to bring down the weight. Reducing your pack weight means that you can do a longer distance and you have more fun. In the previous videos, I talked about the principles, the main principles of reducing pack weight. And I zoomed in on the big three, that's the tent, the backpack and the sleeping bag. And I looked a little bit closer on the backpack. Today I'm going to talk about tents and tarps, hammocks and tarp tents. Most tents are about 1.5 kilo, 2 kilos for a two-person tent. What if I show you a way that you can reduce all of that to about 500 grams, that's about a pound. That saves you at least 1 kilo that you do not have to carry every day. That's a whole liter of water that you do not have to carry every single day. Think about it. So let's talk about this tent. This is a North Face VE25 expedition tent. It weighs a lot, it's about 5 kilos. So is this good for hiking? I don't think so. It is an expedition tent, it's a base camp tent, which means you put it somewhere, you set it up and you stay there for a while. We use this tent a lot if we go to really remote places, like in Alaska, the Bering Sea. We were doing some research on walruses there, and it's a very remote and exposed place. And at some point, a really big storm hit us. And this tent, this VE25, was the only one that was still standing. Well, you might be thinking that this tent is about 5 kilos, so if we split it up, because it can hold 3 people, it's just 1.5 kilo roughly a person, so that's okay. No, it is not, because what if you use a big tarp, for instance, that only weighs about 500 grams, then you only have to carry about 150 grams a person. Saves you another kilo, at least. I like North Face tents. North Face make tents that are sturdy, they can hold up in any terrain, and they're basically great. But they're heavy because of all the materials they use to make it that strong. So what about this tent? This is one of their lightweight two-person tents. Lightweight because it's still 2 kilos. So although it was a great tent and we hiked with it for many years, we now found that one. So this is a tent we nowadays take with us on long distance hikes. This is the Big Ignis, it's the Flycreek UL2, and it is really light. It's only about 1 kilo, so that is 1 kilo less than the tent we just saw from the North Face. And why? Well, the North Face likes to use sturdy materials, so you can put them on some remote places on top of a mountain somewhere. This one, however, is made for long distance hiking. It is ultra light. It is made of different materials that feel kind of flimsy, but it is something like UltraSeal. It is really sturdy, but just really thin. So you should not use this one at really exposed places. But hey, most of the time we hike on a trail and we end up at some place that is more sheltered. So actually, for long distance hiking, this is a really good choice. And there are many tents out there, freestanding tents, that are similar. Most of these sort of tents have a very small vestibule. Because they brought the weight down a lot, that means they had to cut stuff away somewhere. And the vestibule is one of those places. So if you look inside, there's hardly any room to put your backpacks in. If you sleep in there for 2 persons, you will stay dry inside. That's not the issue. But what if it rains for about a week and the rain keeps on pouring down and pouring down? And you want to go pee at night, for instance, with all that rain, all the rain will come into your tent. So there are other options. You can use this kind of tent, or you can go for, let's say, a Hilleberg. They make tunnel tents, but they are more heavier. Okay, let's say you go to a place where you can expect a lot of rain, maybe Norway or England or, I don't know, Washington State maybe. Instead of buying a tent like a tunnel tent, like the Hilleberg, you can also choose a tarp. You can use the tarp to set it over your tent. Our tents stay dry. We could easily go in and out of the tent when it rained at night and no rain came in. So I hear you thinking, what if I only use the tarp instead of the tent with a tarp? Well, that's what a lot of people do. There are not that many people that use a tarp and a tent. This tarp is one of the most lightweight tarps you can get. This was made from UltraSeal and it's from the brand Sea to Summit. It weighs about 350 grams and if I set it up a bit differently, it can hold three people in here easily. So that's basically 100 grams or something a person instead of carrying a tent. Sleeping on the tarps is actually really great. There's always a small breeze coming through that takes away all the condensation. There's lots of room that you can put all your stuff. It's nice, but it does have its downside. Sleeping bag, for instance. If you go to a tarp and just a tarp and you say, well, I leave my tent at home, that saves me another kilo or so. Know that in a tarp, just a tarp, it is always colder than in a tent. So you need a bigger sleeping bag. But instead of putting more stuff into your backpack by buying an extra sleeping bag that weighs more, you can also do something else, and a lot of hikers do that. They use their thermal underwear or their down jacket that they have with them already, and they're going to reuse it. So basically they go into their sleeping bag with their stuff on, so they do not have to buy a thicker sleeping bag. This brand, Sea to Summit, makes a tent that you can hang underneath this big tarp. The whole thing, the tarp and the tent, weighs about 800 grams. That's basically nothing. And it is really big. There are people that use a tarp in a different way, and they use a hammock. I'm not going into detail about hammock camping. You can make a whole program only about hammock camping, and there are already a lot of good videos out there. There are brands out there like Hennessy's and Eno that sell complete sets of hammocks and a tarp for about 1 kilo. Keep in mind, 1 kilo is for one person. Usually you do not sleep with two persons in a hammock. So if you're with two persons, the whole setup will be 2 kilos. So if you're going to hike with a buddy, think about that. The tents I showed you are all self-standing tents with a rain fly on top. But what if you combine those two? That saves a lot of weight. And there are companies that have done that, like Six Moon Designs, you have Z-Packs, for instance. I've listed up some names that you can check out. There are all kinds of new materials out there, like Cuban Fiber and UltraSeal and Dyneema, and they make the tent very light. And those combination tents they made are basically just one outer shell with some mosquito net on the side and a little bathtub underneath. And it saves almost half the weight of a regular tent. I would check them out if I were you, because it can save you a lot of weight with hiking. I sometimes get the question, do you buy a footprint for your tent? Well, no, normally not. Not from the company that sells it, because usually they're too heavy or made from a similar kind of material as the tent itself. So big thorns, like from an acacia or something, they will get through it anyway. So I didn't see the point of bringing all that extra weight. But what I do use is this stuff. This is called Tyvek. It is from a company called DuPont, and it is used in the construction business. So they wrap around buildings with it. So think out of the box. This stuff is so sturdy and it is so waterproof that no thorns, no rocks would go through it at all. It is not really that heavy. It is basically the same weight as a regular footprint, and for some of them even lighter. So think out of the box, just go to a hardware store and see if you can find it or something similar. So, what did we learn today? Well, you've learned that you can bring the weight down from a freestanding tent to at least 1 kilo less than what you're already using right now. If you go to a tarp or a hammock, you can probably bring it down even more to 1/3 of the total weight. It all depends on your personal comfort zone. Keep in mind that a lot of hikers have different gear for different circumstances. So sometimes I use a tarp, sometimes I use a small tent, and sometimes I use a big tent. It all depends on where I'm going. So keep that in mind. Hope you make a wise decision for your next trail. See you out there and on the next video.